Hey friends, welcome to NightGraphics. In this tutorial, I have brought another background design for you. Every time we are coming up with abstract designs, our basic intention is to make you learn that you can experiment with basic functions available in Adobe Illustrator and you can turn simple shapes into interesting designs. Today, you'll learn to draw this design in Adobe Illustrator. We'll draw this design by using rectangle tool, a little bit working with transform options, and the final touch up using effects. So let's start with our drawing. Now first things first, number one, make sure that smart guides are on. And most importantly, don't forget to turn off this align art to pixel grid button. All right, we'll start with drawing background for our design. Get the rectangle tool, draw an artboard sized rectangle. Remove its stroke. And for the fill color, open color panel. Make sure that the fill is selected here. Get HSP options. Here, enter 69 for hue, 63 for saturation, and 90 for brightness. That's it. You may lock this rectangle for now. Open layers panel. And here, lock this rectangle. Now let's come back to our drawing. Rectangle tool is still under selection. Now we'll draw another rectangle. Come here at the center of the artboard. Press and hold Alt key to draw a center outward rectangle and click once. Enter 50 for both width and height values. Remove its fill and give it a stroke of 30 points. Here, make sure that the align option of stroke has been set at align stroke to inside. Now we'll change the color of the stroke. Open color panel. Make sure that stroke is selected here. Bring this hue value at 12, saturation at 80, and brightness at 50. Now we have to rotate this rectangle at 45 degrees. Double click the rotate tool. It has set the axis point at the center of the shape. Here enter 45 degrees for the angle value and press OK. Now copy this rectangle and paste it in front of the original shape. The new copy is under selection right now. Open transform panel. Make sure that the reference point has been set at center and this constraint button is on here. Now add 180 points to its width. Since it's a square, you may add it to any of the width or height values. It's not going to make any difference. Now this new copy is under selection. Copy it or you may simply press Ctrl C and paste it in front. Or you may use the command Ctrl F for that. Now we'll reperform the last transform action of adding 180 points to the width of the shape. You can do it here or open object menu, transform, and here go for this option of transform again. Or you can simply press Ctrl D. It has reperformed the last used transform function and has added 180 points to the width of the shape. Now we have to reperform this whole exercise, right from the copying of the shape and pasting it in front to adding 180 points to its width. This copy is under selection. Copy it, Ctrl C, and paste it in front, Ctrl F. And now to reperform the transform operation, press Ctrl D. Keep repeating this exercise until you get enough frames covering whole of the artboard. Alright, now we have to expand all these shapes. Press Ctrl A to select all of them. Open object menu and here click expand. Alright, deselect all of them. Pick line segment tool. draw a line starting from this anchor point up to this anchor point. Give it a stroke of 10 points. Again, draw a straight line from this top anchor point up to this anchor point. Now keep this line under selection. Open object menu, here path, and go for divide objects below. Now select this line and again go for divide objects below. Now all these parts have been separated. For the next move, select these parts, make them a group. Now select these parts, again make them a group. Now group these parts. And finally, group these ones. Okay, select this group now. Double click here on selection tool button. We've got this move dialog box. Check the preview box for the convenience. We have to move this group by minus 5 pixels horizontally and vertically. Now select this group, get the move dialog box, and this time enter minus 5 pixels for horizontal and 5 pixels for vertical movement value. Select this group now, move it by 5 pixels horizontally and minus 5 pixels vertically. Now move this group, enter 5 pixels for each horizontal and vertical movement value. Okay, let's give it the final effect now. But before that, look at these shapes at the center. I want a single rectangular shape here. For that, select all these shapes. Come here at Pathfinder panel. You can get this panel from Window menu. Now here, go for this merge option. Alright. Now press Ctrl A to select all of them. Open Effect menu, Stylize, pick Drop Shadow. Here keep the mode at Multiply, Opacity value at 75%. Change these X and Y offset values to 6 pixels and press OK. Now finally, we'll clip away this extra portion which is lying out of the artboard. So quickly grab the rectangle tool, come here at this anchor point and draw an artboard sized rectangle. Press Ctrl A to select everything. Now object menu, clipping mask, and here make. And it completes our design. We have completed this drawing with basic rectangle shape and have transformed it using simple transform operation. I hope you have liked this tutorial. And if you have any suggestions or queries, share them in the comment section. We would be happy to answer your queries and come up with your suggested ideas. That's all for now. Thanks for your time. Goodbye.